So I think yesterday we have started this discussion. So we have seen different components of a suspension bridge. So this is your deck slab or roadway, and this is your main cable, and the maximum distance from to the main cable from the horizontal that is called dip or sag, and the main cable is taken over the vertical tower either by using a pulley kind of support or by using a saddle support, and this is called anchor cable. This is anchored to the ground, and this is called the vertical tower and pylon. This is the basically the suspended span of your bridge, and usually this dip or sag will be L/10, where L is the span of your bridge. But usually for suspension bridge, this span will be very large. It may be something like 600 meter to 2000 meter. Okay, and these vertical cables are known as suspenders or hangers. So we have already discussed this. Okay, so this one we have already discussed, and so this support, we can have two types of support. Either it can be a pulley or it can be a saddle type support. It is basically we have provided some rollers so that it will allow the movement, so that there won't be any horizontal force, that there won't be any horizontal force at the top of your tower, but here the horizontal force will be there. So that also we have discussed. This will be the pulley support, so we can find out because of the tensile force in the cable and anchor cable, so we can have some net horizontal force or the shear force, and we can also have some vertical force. So we have to design this vertical tower and its foundation for this vertical force and the movement caused by this horizontal force. But when you come to saddle support, we will not have any horizontal force. The horizontal force, horizontal component of this tensile force will be just equal and opposite, and but we will be having some net vertical force this much. So we have already seen one example for this case. So this problem, as we have already discussed, this is the first one. Take it as a pulley type support, and all the details are given, and we can solve it. So we have already discussed this. And second case, this can be a saddle support, and so we can find out the net vertical force, and the horizontal force will be just zero. There won't be any net horizontal force, that will be just zero. So if you take a suspension bridge, so we have seen the cable structures are flexible. Cable is flexible, it cannot resist any bending moment. So that is why if you apply some loading, it will take or it will imitate the shape of the bending moment diagram. Okay, so that there will be only net tensile force. So that is why we'll be saying that the cables are always funicular structure. It will always take the shape depends on the type of loading. Okay, but if you take a real situation, suppose you have a bridge and some vehicle is passing over the bridge. Okay, so this, suppose this is a truck and it is carrying some heavy load, so that loading will be a point load. And if you apply point load to the cables, what will happen? It will take a piecewise linear shape. So cable may take a shape something like this. So that means it depends on the type of loading. UDL, it will have a parabolic profile, and point load, it will have a piecewise linear shape. So then if the cable profile changes, then what will happen? Your deck will have some movement along. So your deck may go like this. It may go some inclination. So that will cause a lot of discomfort to the passengers and as well as the vehicles. So that is why we should not allow the cable to change its shape. Or in other words, whatever is the loading, whether it is a point load or it is a basically a moving load. Actually, the live load in the bridges are just moving point load, that is a vehicular load, or it can be UDL. Whatever is the loading, we have to maintain the parabolic profile of your cable. To maintain the profile of the cable, so we have to, the cable is already flexible, so we have to stiffen the cable by using some a stiffening girder or using some additional beams at the deck level. So that type of bridges or that type of cables, we can say suspension bridge with a stiffening guard. Okay, so basically we have two types of bridges. The one is called unstiffened and second one is called stiffened bridges. So unstiffened bridges mean we'll have a deck and the deck will be suspended from the main cable through suspenders. But when you come to the stiffened bridges or stiffened cables, so what we have, we will have an addition. In addition to this, so we'll have a stiffening girder like this. So most of the time it will be truss type structures, and this will be calling truss girder. So this one also, it can be a for small bridges, if the load is less, we can also provide a I section beam instead of this truss structure. This is basically we're providing at the deck level, and the deck is supported by this stiffening girder. Okay, and finally the stiffening girder is connected to the main cable. So this girder will help the cable to maintain its shape. Okay, so cable, so main purpose of providing stiffening girder, that is it will stiffen the cable and it also help you to convert the point load. Maybe vehicular load is acting as a point load to the deck. So this point load will be converted to the UDL to the main cable. So that is why the cable will be able to maintain its shape. Okay. So finally, the cable has to maintain its parabola. That means we have whatever is the loading acting in the deck slab, we have to convert that load to a uniformly distributed load. Okay. So that one also, that the UDL point load will be converted to the main cable as a UDL. So that is also possible because of this stiffening girder. Okay. So we'll see this in a systematic order, each component and its function of a suspension bridge. This will be the form of a typical form of an unstiffened cable system. So this is your deck, and deck is directly connected to the cables through the hangers or vertical suspenders. Okay, so this is a simple unstiffened cable system. This may be a bridge, but the span and loading, everything will be very very small. If we have a heavily loaded bridge or long span bridges, we have to provide the stiffening girder to maintain its cable profile. So otherwise it will be unstable. Okay, because your deck will have lot of movement, so finally people will have lot of discomfort if they are using such bridges. Okay, so it is another form of unstiffened cable system. We are not providing any stiffening girder here also. We are just instead of this vertical suspenders, we are providing something like a triangular truss form. Okay, this is also an unstiffened truss bridge. So when you come to the when you come back our suspension bridge, and the main part is all the load is taken by this main cable. Okay, so you can imagine if you have a long span bridge, maybe 1 kilometer span, and it is going to carry a lot of dead load, that is self weight of the structure, also a lot of live load, because a heavy loaded vehicles are passing over it. So the structure has to carry a lot of loads. Okay, the load will be, you can imagine the tensile portion of the cable will be it will be in terms of ton. Okay, so the cable has to carry huge amount of axial tensile force. So this is your cable. Okay, so this is my cable, and it is going to carry the huge tensile force. So finally we have to design the cable. That means we have to find out how much area we have to, what is the area required for the cable. So that is given by the tensile force divided by the permissible stress in the cable. So basically these cables are not just like your mild steel having some strength is 250 megapascal as a yield strength. No. So we cannot use such steel. So usually this steel is made of high strength steel. The typical value of its strength, ultimate tensile strength of that steel may be in the range of 1500 to 2000 megapascal. So it is having strength is 2000 megapascal. So then we can, that is your stress value. So you know the tensile force in some ton, so that the tensile force by the permissible stress or the ultimate strength of your cable will give you the how much area you have to provide. So of course your tensile force is very large, and you will have some 1500 to 2000 megapascal is the tensile permissible tensile stress. So so we can find out the area. So of course the area also will be very very large, because your tensile force is huge. You have to design for some maybe few tons. Okay, so that is why you cannot simply provide a wire. The cable is not just like a wire, it is made in a different way. So you can say that that cable is, you have to call, not cable exactly, you have to call it is a, it is a structural cable. Okay, that means it is made of series of small strand twisted together to form a much larger cable. Or also you can say that cable is multi-strand. Typically it will designate the cable is 6 by 19 or 6 by 37. Okay, so I will explain it, what is this, what does it mean. We'll explain it. The cable will look something like, you can see that this cable is, it is not a single wire. Okay, so how we are making the cable? So we'll combine the wire, we'll combine number of wires and we'll form a strand. Okay, that means something like this. So we have so many wires, and this blue color is a wire. You combined few wires, okay, and just twisted so many wires, and that is called strand. Combine the wires, will it will, that we can, the twist number of wires, okay, that you can say that strand. Then and again you will have a, you will have this type of number of strands. So I have, let us take 3 strands, and each strand will be having some number of wires, okay, like this. Then everything takes something like inside a pipe, or it will, or you can say that the number of strands combined to form a, to form the cables. Okay, that is how your cable is not just a wire. Okay, the main cable is a structural cable, it has to carry a lot of tensile force. So that is why we cannot provide single wire, it cannot take that much load. So we have to combine small wires to form a strand like this. So this is called strand. Okay, these three, this is called strand. We have 3 strands in this case, and then these strands you twist together and that will form the cable. Okay, so it will look something like this. Suppose this is a common way of calling designate the cable, 6 by 19 cable. That means this cable, it is having 6 strand, okay, and 19 wires. The meaning is it is having 6 strand per cable, okay, and 19 wires per strand. So you can see that this is a typical cross section of that type of cables. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 6 strand that will form one cable, and in each strand you will have 19 wires. You will have 19. So maybe we can say that it is, we can see you will have 19 wires. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. So that is a 6 into 37 means it may be something like this. I have 6 into 37 means we'll have maybe 6 strand, and each strand will have 37 wires. Okay, so wires are combined to form this strand, and the combination of wires will be calling strand, and combination of strand, it is just twisted together, something like your rope. Maybe you can see the rope, it is made something like this. Combine the strand to form the cable. So actually we have different types of cables. So maybe it can have a parallel wire system, it will be something like this, or it is called strand rope. So here we have 3, 7 strand, and each strand will be having number of wires, or it can be this form, or it can be this form, like that. So we can have different types of cables. It is just for the information, not need to remember this. So it is another figure showing the, it is your cable, and you can see that each one is called it is called cables, and this is called, these are the strand. Okay, these are the strands. So strands are twisted together or combined to form one cable, and each strand you can see that there are a lot of wires. So, and if you take the cross section, it is the cross section. We have some 7 strands and so many wires in each strand. So it is another figure, and this is actually the parallel wire cable. It is the one cable. Okay, you can see that we can see lot of wires in one cable. Okay, so this system is used in this one, parallel wire strand. So it is used in these type of these bridges. They are used this type of cables, and this bridge we are used this type of cables. Okay, so like that, it is just for your information. So this is how we are making the cable. It is not just like a wire. You should not think like that. That cannot carry that much of tons of tensile force. And also the strength of the cables. Usually, if you say construction field, the tensile strength of steel beam will have value 250 megapascal, mild steel or high strength steel for the reinforcement maybe 500 megapascal. That is the range of the strength of the steel. But nowadays we have high strength steel. So now we have high strength steel. So all these cable structures will be using this high strength steel. That means it ultimate tensile strength may be in the order of 2000 megapascal. So it is, this table is showing in earlier days we do not have that much of high strength steel. In the earlier days in 1830 we had, the strength was 600 megapascal, and later on the we have developed high strength steel. So now we have very high strength steel having strength more than 2000 megapascal. Even that one also available. So not only for the suspension, bridges, some of the pre-stressed concrete structures also we are using the high strength steel. So in the pre-stressed concrete structures, beam or slab, we will be using these cables. Okay, these cables will be using, so that we will also have the strength in the range of 1500 to 2000 megapascal. Okay, so that means we have now the high strength steels are available, so we can use that. You should not think that the strength of the grade of steel will be mild steel. No, it will be high strength steel. The basically that is combined by using wires. Wires are combined to form the strand, and the strands are combined to form the cable. And these are some of the real structures, some of the bridges, and what type of cable which we have used. Okay, so the Golden Gate Bridge you can see, you know that the iconic structure, huge structure. The span itself is something around 1.3 kilometer span. So of course you can imagine how much load will be there. The loading will be very large, so the cables are going to carry a huge tensile force. What type of cables we have used? 450 by 61. 450 by 61, that is the cable which we have used for the Golden Gate Bridge. So what is that 450? You can read here the wires per strand. That means 450 indicate 450 wires in one strand. How many strand we have? Second number indicates strand per cable. So we have 61 strand. Okay, that is the one cable. One cable is having 61 strand, and okay, so like this. This is your cable. So I have 61 strand. Okay, and each strand is having 450 wires. So that is why you can, I will show you some of the photographs. You can see that cable is very huge, but not small. Diameter will be very huge. Okay, so you can also see other type of bridges, what type of strand we have used. So one thing you can see that we are using large number of cables in one, large number of wires in one cable. So this many wires are there in one strand, and this many strands are there in one cable. Okay, so that is your about your cables. And so if you so this is your suspension bridge. Okay, so this is my main cable, and in the real construction we will not stop our main cable like this. Okay, in the suspension bridge the cables are not directly anchored to the top of the towers. Because if you do this type of, if you just connect the main cable to this tower like this, and we are not taking this cable to this side, okay, the anchor cable part is not there, let us assume like that. Then what is the problem? This will have a huge tensile force, and that tensile force will have a horizontal component, and this will cause large bending moment in this tower. So that tower design will become very, very, very difficult. We have to design for large bending moment. So to avoid that, we have to take this main cable over the towers to the other side. So we'll take the main cable to the other side and we'll do the anchoring. So that what is the advantage you're getting? So we'll have some tensile force in the anchor cable also. It may be, it will be different. Okay, and it will have some horizontal component. So finally, the net horizontal force, will be coming, will be less. So that will, that means you will be able to reduce the bending moment also. That is why in the suspension bridge, the cables are not directly anchored to the top of the towers, because the tower in such case have to design, have to resist very high magnitude of moment, includes induced at the at their base by horizontal component of tension in the cable. So this problem is overcome by passing the cable over the guide pulleys or attaching to saddle placed at the top of the tower. So this is overcome by providing a roller pulley support or provide a saddle support. Then you take your main cable and over the towers and anchor in this to the ground in this side. Okay. So these two types of support we have already discussed.